What to do if the chainsaw cuts crookedly? First, a little useful theory, then I'll show you how to fix it easily and cost-effectively. Most of the time this can be fixed. And so that it doesn't bother you in the future. Let's find out the factors. The first factor, uneven wear of the chain teeth. Suppose you cut a nail with a chainsaw. The chainsaw starts to cut noticeably worse, and we start pushing the tire harder, forcing it to saw with the same enthusiasm. What happens to the chainsaw at this time? Sharper saw teeth cut wood easily. The teeth caught on the nail do not cut the layer of wood, but they roll over like a car wheel over a bump. But the car has shock absorbers. And chainsaw chains and bars do not have them. The chain starts to press harder on one of the ribs, resulting in uneven wear and tear. In addition, there is also wear on the chain shanks along the bar groove and the groove itself. The chain on the tire starts wobbling. This is backlash, and the longer you turn a blind eye to it, the more serious the wear and tear will be. The second factor that accelerates the wear of the tire, wrong or untimely tensioning of the chain. The chain on a chainsaw is the most capricious thing. According to the instructions, the tension should be as follows. When you try to lift the chain, you should see three shanks, but with the different length of the chainsaw bar and the strength of the fingers, this does not work out very well. A properly tensioned chain on a cold chainsaw should not sag and should spin without effort. But there are peculiarities. On a slightly worked chainsaw, the chain heats up first, and it slackens slightly. We learned physics at school and remember that metal expands when heated. It's okay. But there are people who do not take this into account and want to pull the chainsaw chain. What happens next? Let's say that you shut down the saw. The chain will cool down and become overstretched. If you keep sawing, after a while, after the chain will heat up and increase the tire. And again, the chain will be over-tightened. An overstretched chainsaw chain increases the load on the bearings, sprocket, bar, and stretches. Not only overstretched but also blunt chain stretches quickly on a hot chainsaw, which together greatly accelerate tire and chain wear. I think you've already guessed that if you put a new chain on the old tire, nothing will change noticeably. The chainsaw will cut crookedly. Can this be fixed? In most cases, yes. The chain should be sharpened on a professional machine. Just flip the tire. If you've already turned it upside down, and the tire has uneven wear on both sides, buy a new tire, or fix the old one. To align the chainsaw bar, we need an angle piece, vise, a grinder and a new deburring wheel. But first, let's make one cut. You can see with the naked eye that the saw is going sideways. You need to remove and check the tire. Place the tire on a flat table and set up an angle. This tire doesn't even want to stand. There is less wear and tear on this one. But there's also clamp a grinder with a stripping disc and a vise. Raise the table to the level with the wheel of the power grinder. I put a steel pancake and a flat piece of chipboard, and I secured it with a clamp, and then used an angle to set the exact angle and secure the angle grinder. I'm going to turn on the grinder and wipe off each side several times. Visually better. What does the angle gauge show? Almost perfectly. Check that the chain tails are completely hidden in the bar groove. If the groove has become shallow, the tire will have to be replaced. Let's assemble the chainsaw and see how it saws now. Saws better. No more sideways. Just need a sharpening. Don't switch it up, there's more. What else can go wrong with the chain? While sawing, chips or twigs can get between the loose chain and the bar. If the chainsaw is not equipped with a chain catcher, and the tire is elongated, the chain can cause serious injury to the ankle by wrapping around it. When the chain slips off the tire, the chain catcher takes the brunt. But in addition to this damage to the sprocket, if the chain has fallen repeatedly, deep grooves form on the sprocket. These grooves do not allow the chain to be properly tensioned. The chain slackens in the furrow. When it pops out of the furrow, it gets very tight. If there are grooves on the sprocket, change the sprocket. Otherwise the chain could break and the bearings could crumble. May fail and the sprocket welded to the clutch disc will fall off. A similar thing happened to this asterisk. And finally, even a new chain can break because of improperly installed connecting plates at the riveting point, wherever you buy a new chain. Be sure to inspect the connecting link. The rivet will be slightly larger or brighter. And check if the connection strips are correctly positioned. Some chains have an arrow on the bars that indicates the direction. If there is no arrow, the correctness of the slats can be determined by the front support of the slat. It will be bigger than the back one. A wrongly placed one connecting strip will be skewed. The load on the connecting link will increase and the rivet will fail. That seems to be all. Keep an eye on the condition of your chainsaw sprocket, bar, and chain. If my video was helpful, don't forget to like it and subscribe to the channel.